Something magical happens when the monsoon cloud starts their journey to the western ghats of India towards the end of June. Mother Earth opens up her hidden treasure. The eruption of life happens as soon as the first drops of the rain hits the dried soil and leaves the most hypnotic smell of the soil. Army of ants emerge. Grasshoppers start hopping around the plants. Mantises start spraying. The sky fills with vivid colors of winged angels called butterflies. This opens up for us once in a year opportunity of macro photography that we never ventured in our past. That's how started our 3 days journey towards monsoon, Malnadu, Malabar pit viper and macro photography. What was waiting for us was one of the most beautiful journey we ever took. As usual, like any of my previous wildlife photography journeys, I could not sleep more than a couple of hours the previous night. In the history of mankind, first time ever, I was waiting 5 minutes before Guru arrived to pick me up. Best part, this time neither I overpacked stuffs nor under. Every essential thing was neatly packed a week before the journey. None of the things were left behind by me while going or even coming back. Once again, that was first of its kind. To acclimatize to the world we are entering into, Mother Earth started a slight drizzle even before we crossed Tumkur. What started as a drizzle turned into torrential rain even before we reached Lakkavalli, which gently reminded Guru and Dinesh that they had forgotten the most essential item for this adventure, the umbrella. They had to buy umbrella in Lakkavalli in the middle of the rain. Guru forgetting essential stuffs. Even that was first in the history of mankind. Thanks to the constant reminder phone calls of our host, guide and mentor Vinay, we knew that the rain was lashing this region with its full might from last 2 days. There were roadblocks due to overflowing bridges, landslides, even tree fallings. We had to take a roundabout journey of additional 50 kilometers to reach our destination, Balagatte Homestay and Singaramadilu. My brother Shivu and our host Vinay were already waiting for us. So was delicious hot lunch. Thanks to the basic training from our dear friend and pro macro photographer Shashi, a week before, we had a little knowledge about the gear we had to carry and the subjects we were about to face. Personally, I carried my ever trustworthy Muse Canon 70 Mark II along with it. Canon 430 EX RT3 flash, radiant diffuser custom made by Mr. Girish Gowda, Canon 100mm 1:1 USM L series macro lens rented from Toehold Photography, Rhinox 250 borrowed from Shashi. Apart from the camera gears, I had carried GoPro Hero 5, iPhone 12 for my videos, other important stuffs like long beam torch, head torch, extra memory cards, additional pair of cells for flash and torches, hiking shoes, waterproof poncho from Decathlon, an umbrella, extra socks, camouflage dresses, anti-bug spray like Odomos, emergency medicines and anti-leech socks from Wild Roar. When you are traveling for the first time to Western Ghats during monsoon season, no matter how prepared you are, nothing makes you mentally ready for what you are about to witness and experience. Especially around Agumbe and surrounding rainforest, which is called Chirapunji of South. The rain here is not one season of the year. It's not one event. It's a lifestyle. You just can't separate the rain when you are talking about this region. Hence we call this region as Malenadu or Malenadu in Kannada. The rain here is like a marathon runner who slows down for a couple of seconds to take deep breath and then again starts long and hard run towards the finish line. If you are talking about the rain, then how can we not talk about the next obvious thing of the rainforest? The leech. These harmless looking blood sucking worms enter your clothes where you never thought had any opening. We protected our legs with anti-leech socks, sturdy shoes and rugged trousers. But we truly underestimated these morons. With full-sleeved shirt, which was then covered by a poncho and then umbrella on top of it, we thought this three-layered fortress is impenetrable. Gosh, we were so wrong.
As long as they are restricted towards Otte, it is good. Not further down.
ಜಿಗ್ಗಿಜುಕ್ವಾಗಿ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಅನ್ಕೋ.
Unless you are allergic to the leech bites, there is absolutely nothing to fear. Agreed that their bites are messy and bloody due to the anticoagulant secretions they produce while sucking the blood. But they are painless bites. Sure, their after bite wound takes time to heal. You might feel the mild itching sensation for next couple of weeks, but the memories of wild and rain overweighs these small hiccups. Be it around trees, plants and pond in Balagatte homestay, or around bird hide, lake, water stream or even jungle path in Singaramadilu, the treasure of macro photography is infinite. Ladybugs, ants, grasshoppers, frogs, spiders to breathtaking snakes. There is no end for exploration. Best part, these wildlings do not restrict you and your photography only for mornings and evenings. If you have the strength and patience, you can explore throughout the day and even night as well. Especially during the night, this world opens up in its double capacity. Small eggs under the leaves, spiders with their quills, molting cicadas, singing frogs, or patient snakes waiting for their prey. This nocturnal world is an absolute stunner. Carrying complicated equipments, holding umbrella, focusing the tiny subject back and forth while bending, kneeling, standing, and even crawling takes you to a breaking point. Your neck and back kind of become numb. Your body asks you, "What the hell are you doing to me?" And then you suddenly hear, "Come fast, I spotted a Malabar pit viper." Without even wasting your time to heed for the body's request, you run to that place. Every pain vanishes in that moment. If you have an open mind and no specific wishes in the wild, from colorful mushrooms to venomous vipers, every image you make is frame-worthy. Yes, your luck plays a very important role as well. If the rain doesn't stop at all, the activity of wildlife becomes lesser and lesser. Even for few minutes, if the rain stops, that's your time to hunt. We witnessed 7 types of snakes, 6 to 10 types of frogs, and countless types of other subjects. Some are patient enough to give perfect pose, and many you just have to observe and enjoy. Unfortunately, it is at the same interval when the rain stops, these absolutely beautiful snakes venture out in search of food and become victims of roadkill. And some even get killed by people as well. The cost of human development is always paid by those species who can't vote.